Hello friends, welcome to the medicine world. Hope you studied our previous lectures by heart. Okay, without wasting a second, let's discuss our today's topic, that is growth assessment or monitoring in a newborn. It is basically divided into two categories. The first one, age-dependent anthropometric parameters, and second one, age-independent anthropometric parameters. Anthropometric, that means the measuring parameters. Okay, so let's discuss today age dependent anthropometric parameters. We will be discussing the second one, that is age independent anthropometric parameters, by the next lecture. Let's discuss today the first topic. So now in the age dependent anthropometric parameters, we will be discussing the six topics, that is first one, weight, second one, length or height, third one, that is head circumference, fourth, chest circumference, fifth, upper segment to lower segment ratio, and the sixth one, that is growth velocity in a newborn. Now, talking about the first one, that is weight, it is the most sensitive parameter. What does that mean? It means that if the baby is not getting the proper nutrition, then the first thing to be affected or the first thing to be noticed, it will be the weight of the baby. And weight of the baby by birth is 2.5 to 3 kg. On an average, it is about 2.8 kg. The weight of the baby gets doubled by the age of 6 months. This is the most common question that was asked in various medical exams. Remember that this question can also be asked in another form, that is the weight of the baby gets 100% of its birth weight by the age of, so the answer will be again 6 months. Guys, do remember this by heart, that the newborn gains the weight by the age of 6 months, the weight gets doubled 3 times by the age of 1 year, 4 times by the age of 2 years, 5 times by the age of 3 years, 7 times by the age of 7 years, and 10 times by the age of 10 years. And talking about the another topic, that is absolute weight gain, that means the weight gain in a day. It will be like 0 to 3 months, it will be 30 gram per day, 4 to 6 months, it will be increasing by 20 gram per day, 7 to 9 months, it will be increasing by 15 gram per day, and for 10 to 12 months, it will be increasing by 12 gram per day. Now talking about the length or the height of a newborn, what does the length mean? It is measured when the baby is less than 2 years. It is measured in the supine position and with the help of infantometer. While the height is measured when the baby is more than 2 years in a standing position and with the help of a stadiometer. Now, there are two aspects of a stadiometer. The first one, that is the Frankfurt plane, and the second one, that is the biauricular plane. What is Frankfurt plane? It is a horizontal aspect and it is a line joining the lower border of the orbits to the floor of the external auditory meatus. We can define the Frankfurt plane as a head in the horizontal, exactly in the horizontal position where the lower orbits of the floor and the external auditory meatus stands in a one horizontal plane. Now the conditions that are in the Frankfurt plane, that is standing straight with the bare feet, both feet touching each other and the heels touching the stadiometer. This is the Frankfurt plane. Alright, so now let's discuss the another plane, that is biauricular plane. In that only one condition is there, that heels, buttocks, shoulder and occipital bone all must be touching the wall of the stadiometer. As you can see in the image, the person who is standing at the stadiometer, the heels, buttocks, shoulder and occipital are touching the wall of the stadiometer. Now, talking about the length at the birth, it is 50 cm and the length gets doubled by the age of 4 years. Remember that in the weight, it was getting doubled by the age of 6 months, while the length gets doubled by the age of 4 years. By birth, it is 50 cm. By 1 year, it will be 75 cm. By 2 years, 90 cm. By 3 years, 95 cm. And by 4 years, it will be getting 100 cm. That is, the 100% of the birth length is achieved by the age of 4 years. After 4 years, it will be increasing by 6 cm per year till the age of puberty, that is around 12 to 13 years. And after puberty, it will be increasing by more than 6 cm per year. Remember this also by heart as you remembered the weight. Now let's discuss about the third parameter, that is head circumference. It is measured from the two aspects, that is anterior and posterior. From the anterior, the supraorbital ridge, and the posterior, the occipital protuberance is considered for the measurement of the head circumference. The head circumference by birth, it will be 34 cm, but it ranges from 33 to 35 cm. By 0 to 3 months, it will be increasing by 2 cm per month, so the total will be 6 cm after 3 months. For 4 to 6 months, it will be increasing by 1 cm per month, so the total will be increased by 3 cm. By 7 to 12 months, it will be increasing by 0.5 cm per month, so the total will be 3 cm increase. So that after a year, the head circumference will be increased by 12 cm. So the total increase in head circumference after 1 year, it will be 34 cm, which was by birth, and 12 cm increment by 1 year. So the total head circumference after 1 year will be 46 cm. Now let's assume a condition where if the head circumference is increasing by more than 1 cm per 2 weeks, then we can suspect it as a congenital hydrocephalus, because it is the most common cause during the birth. The most common cause of congenital hydrocephalus is aqueductal stenosis. What is aqueductal stenosis? Between the 3rd and 4th ventricle, there is the aqueduct of Sylvius, which drains the cerebrospinal fluid. But the obstruction to the cerebrospinal fluid occurs in the aqueductal stenosis. It will cause the increased head size of a baby. Basically, the head size is divided into two categories: microcephaly, that means the less head size. If the head circumference is less than minus 3 standard deviation, then it will be called as microcephaly. And the macrocephaly, that is large head size, if the head circumference is larger than 2 standard deviation, then it will be macrocephaly. Also, aqueductal stenosis is one of the example of macrocephaly only. Guys, also if you are enjoying this video, a subs would be massively appreciated. I had just started a channel, but tons of videos are on my way. Let's discuss the fourth parameter, that is the chest circumference. By birth, the head circumference is larger than the chest circumference by 3 cm. By 9 months to 1 year, the head circumference becomes equal to the chest circumference. After 1 year, the head circumference must be less than the chest circumference. There is one jellyfish ratio, a parameter for the head circumference to chest circumference ratio. If it is larger than the one after 1 year, then the baby will be called as malnourished baby. And the chest circumference is measured at the level of nipples, midway between inspiration and expiration. So now let's discuss about the fifth parameter, that is upper segment to lower segment ratio. Upper segment can be defined as a sitting height, and the lower segment can be defined as a length from pubic symphysis to the toe. So we can conclude that upper segment equals to height minus the lower segment. And by birth, the upper segment to lower segment ratio is 1.9:1. By 1 year, it becomes 1.5:1. By 3 years, it becomes 1.3:1. By 7 to 10 years, it becomes 1:1. And after 10 years, it becomes 0.9 or say 0.8:1. Here, the important thing to remember is that the upper segment to lower segment ratio becomes equal at the age of 7 to 10 years. This is the important thing to remember for the exams. Let's discuss the last parameter, that is growth velocity. It is the increase in extra height after the birth. It will be called as growth velocity. It is as simple as that, but the important thing to remember is that it is the best parameter. Do you remember the first one, the weight? It was called as the most sensitive parameter, while the growth velocity, it is called as the best parameter.